everybody. This is Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com, and today I am transplanting my seedlings into a bigger pot. Now, this is going to take a multiple series because not all of them grow at the same rate, and so the ones that are ready are going to be put into their pots today, and I'm using what's called a cow pot. Our friend Ann told us about these little pots. They're like your paper mache pots that you find some of the plants coming in, but they're made out of cow pies. Yep, poop. They don't smell like poop.
Well, thank the Lord for that.
But the nice thing about these is, once you put your seedling in there, it grows and grows, and the roots can go right through the pot itself once you plant it in the ground, and there's no transplanting shock for the bigger plant now that is ready to be put into the ground. So, cow pots.
So it decomposes.
It does. And it adds, obviously, nutrients from the manure that it was made of. Okay, so the things I'm planting today are the pineapple tomatoes that we loved so dearly last year. These are seeds that we saved over the winter. And
because they're heirlooms.
They are. And so I'm just making a little space in this pot here with a spoon. And then I'm going to reach under this dome and push out the little spongy peg. And you can see that the roots are coming out already. Into the hole it goes. No transplanting shock here because nobody's digging. All right, so now I know I could have put a little more soil in these, but that's okay. I'll just borrow. Make sure it's firm so that there's no air pockets, and make sure you know what you're planting. I'm putting a little name on there.
And again, you're using old Venetian blinds that work beautifully for plant markers.
The vinyl blinds, right, yeah. That I just cut up and write on. And these will be going in here. I'll give them a good watering, and they'll go back into our little greenhouse to get another little head start on getting into the garden sooner or later. You notice that there's two here.
Three.
Or three here. Yes, there are. When I planted them, I planted more than one seed, just in case. Sometimes a seed isn't ready to germinate, or it's a dud. So I planted more. Some of them, if they were just really combating each other, we snipped them off. This may happen with these, depending on who grows better. Who decides to dominate, the other ones will probably go.
Well, that's part of the thinning process.
Mm-hmm. So there you go. Those are all the pineapple ones. The next are going to be the pomodoro. So same process. Make your hole. Pop it out. Nice roots coming along there.
Mm-hmm.
Put it in. I'm going to pop these out right away because it's easier this way. Since I can do it real quickly, they're not going to dry out in between. I can find the right hole. Ooh, where are you? It's got to be here somewhere. There's one. Come on now. There you are. So the last ones I'm going to do today are the Peach Blow Suttons. These are the ones that we had from last year. They are also heirloom, We save the seeds from these. These are the ones that have the... Oh, thank you, Pepper. Yes, thank you for your help. Would you like to lick my fingers? These are the ones that have the little fuzzy skin on them, rather than the shiny, regular tomato skin. They have the fuzzy skin like a peach, but not quite that fuzzy. Very tasty. They get about this big, and they are more squat than tall. Interesting type of tomato. Well, the last step is to water them in, and you want to make sure that the water is going to go all the way down and come out the bottom. Oops, stand up there. Sorry about that. And then these will go back in the greenhouse where it'll keep them warm. They are not yet ready to be out in our climate, which is going to be in the 30s again tonight. And once this soil is saturated, you'll see that the pot itself, just like a paper mache pot, will get darker. And then you know it's moist enough.
I notice you're using filtrated water too.
Yep.
Do you have a reason for that?
Well, eventually they're going to be out in the rain, of course, but I don't want any of the chlorine from the city water to be in here, or I don't think we have the softened water coming up as cold, but I'm just making sure that it's getting the purest water that we have at this point. And the reason I'm putting it in a tray like this rather than just leaving it here is because there are grooves in the bottom, and so they're not going to be sitting in water, but the water will still be there to add to the
moisture,
humidity in the air. So I think for now we're going to say into the hothouse you go.
Personally, I think I would add a little bit more soil to those that are the plugs that
high.
Are sticking up. Yeah.
Okay.
We
can do that.
Okay.
And that's another reason you want to water right away, is because soil does sink down. You don't want it to be firmly packed when you put it in there, compacted too much. You don't want to make the roots work harder than they need to. But sometimes when you add the water, it'll show you that you need some more.
Well, you know how they mentioned to bury tomatoes even deeper so that mm-hmm. the stem itself starts to establish a stronger root base?
Yes. I don't know if you want to do that when they're seedlings, though. Get some more water. I'm now out of... Here we go. We got them all watered. And now I'm going to move them.
What kind of tomatoes were these that you just bought?
These are the Peach Blow Sutton.
Oh, that's right. Yep.
And they are different kind of leaves. Now, hopefully I've marked them correctly when I saved them. But then the Peach Blow did have a different kind of leaf, if I remember correctly. It was one that we hadn't seen before, so we'll see. All right, so up these go. It's getting much heavier. Whoa. Could have been something else. Center them under these lights. Now it's good to keep circulation going since a lot of them have started to sprout. We'll just keep it going for a while, not all night, not all day, but just kind of on and off. and we will show you how these do in a couple of days.
Well, we have given our seedlings a chance to get a little bit bigger, and those are the ones that we transplanted first. Those are all tomatoes. Even that little one, that's a peach blow. Right, yeah. So they have different kinds of leaves on them. And then as the seedlings start to get their second leaves, I've been transplanting them into pots. Not every day, but as they get them. So they're all in different stages of growth and different experiments. Now this one, I started directly in the pots. And they've taken a long, long time. But some of them are coming. And then these were transplanted the other day, and these are transplanted today. And these are sweet alyssum seeds that I've almost killed off a couple of times because they got too dry. And those, again, are more peach blow Sutton tomatoes in the back. We've tried a couple of different ways of growing seedlings. We've used the biodomes that have the cover and the little sponge inserts. That's how we did almost all of them, except for that one tray. And varying amounts of success. I did use some of my older sponges that insert into the foam, and I guess I didn't clean them well enough. I'm guessing that's what it is, because I did end up with some mold on the tops of them, and those are the ones that didn't do well. So I've taken all the ones that are still working on sprouting, and they are in my last biodome. Everything else is over here transplanted.
Well, you do have some in the plant room though too.
And
we have another tray in there.
Start some more in there. Yes, yeah. I did. I forgot about those. Yes. So they're all in varying stages.
I notice you've got your cacti out here now.
Yes, these are the ones that I started they were from pieces of cactus that our good friend Deb gave us last summer. And right before it was going to freeze, I thought, I didn't plant these outside like I intended to. So, when was that? In November?
I think so.
I put them into pots.
Well, you just started cutting them.
I just cut them up and put them in pots. They are all very happy.
Yeah.
They have little ears coming out of them, and so they're real happy. Now they're in the sun, so they'll be even happier. Those can go outside once the weather, well, they could go out now because they are perennials.
Yeah. Well, we did have a couple of questions you mentioned about the light systems that we use.
Yes.
We showed this industrial one here, which was so hot.
Right.
And
this
so
one got really, really, it says it doesn't get hot, but it did. And it, like I said, it almost killed off my sweet alyssum. So we don't have that one on at the moment, but we do have the other grow lights that we've had before that you had set up in here. And then another long one down below.
And those are 4-footers. Those are supposedly, full spectrum.
Those are full spectrum, yeah. Right.
But let's go into the plant room and take a look at those.
Okay, let's. We are now in what I call the green room, and Rick has always thought of as the plant room. It used to be our children's bedroom. Over the years, each one of them had it as a room. It's now growing plants, so it could be a plant. These are the succulents that we bought early in the winter. We were planning on donating them for the Ozaukee County Master Gardener's plant sale, which was supposed to take place in May, which has, of course, been canceled. So we have them, and hopefully we will still have them next spring, and they'll be bigger, and we can charge more for them. So they'll be a bigger fundraiser for the Master Gardeners. But we are also starting seeds up here as well. These are vegetables up here, mostly tomatoes,
And these are marigolds, the small French marigolds that are so good for your garden. These are from seeds that were over, they were over a year old when I planted them. I have planted some of those three different times. So when you say seeds are good over time, they are, but they all aren't good.
But they don't
anymore.
All germinate.
No.
So you lose the percentage every year.
Sometimes you just have to keep planting them and eventually you'll get a bunch of them. Well, this is a different system than what we have out in the greenhouse. It started out as this. It's a tray, and in the tray are little peat pots made out of peat moss, and they're hard. And what you do is when you're ready to plant, there's a tray, and you put all your little pots in here, your pods in here, and you put warm water over them. And as the water soaks in, the peat disintegrates into
expands.
And expands, and it falls apart, and it becomes the soil that you're going to start your seeds in. So that's how these have started. I think if I do this again, I would put two pods in, because you can see they really don't, to me, they don't have enough soil in them to get them going. But it's not stopping them, because there they are. These are peppers over here that I tried out in the other room that didn't work. And then this is a Rutgers tomato, and still waiting for these guys. And over here we have, I can't read my own writing. Oh, those are Bush Roma's tomatoes over there. So while some of them are doing well, and these were all new seeds, some aren't, but give it a try.
Yeah.
This is a plant stand that my husband fashioned.
Actually, this isn't a plant stand.
No, I know. It turned into a plant stand.
Oh, yeah.
It's a kitchen shelving unit that we got at Home Depot.
It's an industrial unit. It's 4 foot long, 20 inches deep, and about 6 foot tall. And you can adjust the shelves to whatever height you want them.
Mm-hmm. And then you got these cool lights, full spectrum, obviously.
Yep, and then I bought you a power strip on the side here, which makes plugging in all the different devices.
Right, because we have heating pads and lights. And then the nice thing about it is that you just pull the lights off when you're done with them at night. So
are you pleased with it?
I am pleased with it. It turned out really well. I'm glad. And these now have space to grow, and they can get this tall before next year. If you enjoyed this video over time, please give us a thumbs up. We'd appreciate that. And if you have comments or questions, if you've had success or failures with your seeds and your succulents, we'd love to hear about it. And as always, if you'd like to become part of our garden family, down here, over here, a little more over here, there is a subscribe button. You are most welcome to subscribe and become part of our garden family. Bye for now. Happy spring.
What happens when these are 10 times the size they are now?
I think I'm going to be doing more repotting.
There you go. You can start propagating them then.
Connect with us on YouTube.